In today's video, we'll see this new two-stroke engine that uses valves and does not burn oil. This engine was recently patented by Japanese manufacturer Mazda, and they plan to use it in their cars, so we'll see how it works. First, we'll start with a conventional two-stroke engine so we can later understand its differences. When the piston goes up, it generates a vacuum, causing the mixture to enter the crankcase. Then, when the piston goes down, it pre-compresses the mixture and sends it to the cylinder through the ports. Finally, when the piston goes up, the port closes. Compression begins. The spark is fired and combustion occurs, which pushes the piston down, delivering power. Finally, the exhaust port is uncovered at the same time that pressurized gases enter from the crankcase to refresh the mixture. In this process, some waste is produced as some of the mix passes through the exhaust. In this two-stroke engine, there's one spark for each revolution of the crankshaft. The ports are fixed and depend on the movement of the piston. Their opening degrees cannot be changed. On the other hand, the four-stroke engine has well-established cycles. Intake, the valve closes, compresses, combusts, opens the exhaust valve, and empties the cylinder to start the process again. In this engine, one ignition occurs for every two revolutions of the crankshaft. This means that the theoretical volumetric performance of the four-stroke engine is half that of the two-stroke. However, the four-stroke engine does not use the crankcase to draw in the mixture, which means that it can store oil in there without problems. In addition, the exhaust cycle is unique and not shared as in a two-stroke engine, improving the efficiency of each drop of fuel and giving more miles per gallon. Now, how can we merge these two engines and get the best of both worlds? Well, first, before getting to the final solution, we have to look at the two-stroke diesel engine. These engines are widely used in giant engines such as ships and some locomotives. I'm going to explain this engine very quickly as a review, since there's a video on my channel about two-stroke diesels. The two-stroke diesel engine, unlike the two-stroke gasoline engine, instead of using the crankcase for intake, uses a compressor to force air into the cylinder through a lower port. It also has exhaust valves at the top, which produces an excellent air renewal, leaving clean air for future diesel burning. A belt-driven compressor must be used instead of a turbo, because compressors work better at low RPM, necessary to start and keep the engine at idle. If a turbo were used, when the engine rotates at low RPM, the turbo would not work. By not having to use the crankcase, it can be filled with oil and lubricate the engine. The problem is that it still has ports, and some oil passes through it and ends up inside the combustion chamber, burning. Furthermore, a two-stroke diesel engine is only efficient when it rotates at low RPM and is large in size. And since it does not fit under the hood, it simply is not used in cars. Now yes, here is the new Mazda patent. Let's analyze it in detail to understand this engine that seems simple, but is not. First, we have an engine with camshafts, intake, and exhaust valves. The ports were removed and the crankcase can be used to store oil. It basically looks like a four-stroke engine. We also have the belt-driven compressor, as in the two-stroke diesel. When the piston reaches bottom dead center, the intake valve opens. And even though the piston goes up, the compressor forces air to enter. The intake valve closes, compress, and the direct injector adds fuel at 700 bar or 10,000 PSI. The spark is fired and the combustion drives the piston downward. When all the energy of the gases has been used, the exhaust valve opens. Thousands later, the intake valve opens. The compressor forces fresh air in and the exhaust gases exit through the correct place. The intake port passes above the camshaft and points toward the cylinder wall to direct airflow. The intake valve housing is also special with its shape. It opens the airflow towards the cylinder wall to create a loop and improve scavenging. The intake and exhaust process is carried out at the same time. With the help of the compressor, it is basically possible to convert the four-stroke engine into a two-stroke. Now, the camshafts rotate at the same speed as the crankshaft, while in a four-stroke, it's half the speed. The engine also incorporates additional technology, such as variable camshafts, which allows an EGR system. Under low load conditions, the exhaust valve closes early and prevents exhaust gases from escaping. This exhaust gas stays in the cylinder, completing the volume and increasing compression, giving more power, reducing pumping losses, and keeping compression high. The high temperature of the already burned gases also allows the engine to run without using the spark plug, since, as in all diesel engines, the mixture is injected at the last moment and ignites due to compression and temperature. The injection pressure is greater than 700 bar, 3 times higher than a gasoline engine and close to the diesel injection pressure. This mode dramatically increases engine performance at low load, delivering more miles per gallon. Something that must be respected in an engine is the AFR, since it ensures good performance. AFR stands for air-fuel ratio. In this case, it's 14.7 to 1, which means that we need 14.7 parts of air for each part of fuel. Therefore, instead of entering new air into the engine and keeping AFR okay using fuel, we can retain already burned exhaust gases. Remember that these gases are inert. This means that even if we have a large engine, we can fill almost everything with burned exhaust gas. Then, only a minimal part of clean air, a pinch of fuel, and finally obtain performance from a much smaller engine. Now, in full power situation, the camshaft places in full scavenging position and take out all the exhaust gases. The cylinder is renewed with fresh air. Fuel injection starts earlier to mix well. In this mode, the spark plug is used to ignite the mixture. Basically, this engine incorporates Mazda's SkyActiv technology in an improved way, which uses excessive ignition timing and takes advantage of knocking, maximizing power. In summary, Mazda's two-stroke engine combines everything. Valves like a four-stroke engine that allow precise control of the gas flow. Diesel EGR system, which reuses gases to keep compression high and lower emissions. 1 spark per RPM like two-stroke engines, doubling the use of the cylinder and reducing the size of the engine. No oil burned. Air compressor like two-stroke diesel. SkyActiv system to increase the performance of each drop of gasoline and burn it as if it were diesel, achieving more efficiency. And finally, a very high compression ratio close to 16 to 1. We hope that this engine begins to be sold soon so we can hear its sound. And who knows, it may sound like this. Like a V8? Since it has twice as many ignitions as a four-cylinder. Or like a two-stroke. Or like both at the same time. Do you think it will delay the arrival of electric cars? My name is Francis, and if you like the video, don't forget to like it and comment what you think. You can also subscribe and leave your super thanks. See you next time!